Okay, we're officially recording.
Okay, great. So let me share my desktop here. I think that worked. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do, Alana already showed us all of our supplies. So I'm going to start with the audio cable and the, you're right, I don't have a better term either. The female end is what we're gonna use first to make the battery interrupter. So you can kind of decide where you wanna cut it based on how far away from your toy you wanna be and how much you want sticking out. I'm gonna cut it like, I don't know, 6-8 inches or so. Just making this up. So then you'll put aside the other half and you just have your female half. And then we're going to learn how to strip wires. If you have wire strippers, awesome. If not, with your scissors, you're gonna kind of cut just halfway so that you're getting just the coating, the black coating off, and then kind of rotate your scissors until the whole coating comes off and it can be pulled off. I'm gonna use wire strippers because I like to cheat.
A little tip I have from doing this last time, I was like being very gentle with my scissor at first and like kind of slowly trying to scrape off the what is it called? Like insulation or whatever.
Yeah.
But what I discovered is you really have thick. To actually put a dent with your scissor in it until you see the wires inside. Like I was sort of trying, I was like literally gradually scraping off the black part, but no, you want to actually like make a cut like I did. And then you can pull it off more easily. You don't want to like totally cut it, but you have to be a little bit more forceful, at least than I realized in the beginning. Okay. So yeah, then I was able to just pull it off.
And the wonderful thing is if you accidentally cut all the way through, like no big deal. Just start right. again at a point further
yeah.
down.
Exactly. Yeah.
Oh, and I should say you want a good inch or two of space.
Is this about right, Kayla?
Yes, it's beautiful. Now, my wire has all these little coppery strands in it. You can see that. And those are the grounding wires, and I don't need those, so I'm going to cut them off. If your wire just has a red strand and a white strand, then you're good. Is everyone down to just a red and a white wire?
Megan says she has red, white, and yellow wires.
Well, that's exciting. I say pick two because you only want two. I would pick red and white, but it doesn't actually matter. So once you are down to your two wires, assuming that those are also coated, you want to also strip the coating off of those. So it doesn't have to be the full length all the way down to the black, maybe just halfway, just to expose the interior of both of those wires. So now I'm going to take my piece of cereal box and I'm going to think about how big I want it. If I'm using a toy with like AA batteries, I'm gonna maybe make like a square that's like a quarter of an inch. I don't know. If you're using like C size batteries, then make a square that'll cover the end of your battery terminal. And it's better to go too big than too small if you're not sure.
So Caitlin, you're talking about like, okay, if this is my battery, I want this square to cover, the flat side, right? Or doesn't matter.
It doesn't actually matter. Yeah. Traditionally, okay. The sticky just, outside, but
just yeah. To cover this part of the battery.
Okay. Thank you for that visual.
Okay. And how many do you need of those?
One square of cardboard.
Cool.
And then in a size just a little bit smaller than that, you're going to want two squares of your copper foil tape. So you only need to interrupt the circuit in one place. So you're only going to need one square, no matter how many batteries you have.
That's nice. And the size of the copper, does that need to cover?
You're going to want it slightly smaller than your cardboard.
Okay.
So the idea is that you don't want it to accidentally go all the way to the edge of the cardboard, because then the two copper pieces on each side might touch and the circuit might continue to flow.
Gotcha.
All right. So what's going to happen is that one of our wires is going to go on one side of the cardboard square, and the other wire is going to go on the other side. So we're going to sandwich the cardboard in between these two pieces, but we're going to want to make sure of two things. First, we're going to want to make sure that it's overlapping a little. The insulation, let me flip it to the red side. You want the insulation to overlap the cardboard a little bit, just for safety, so that the bare wires aren't sticking out off of the cardboard. And you're going to adhere that using your copper tape, if you have one that's adhesive. If you just have regular copper foil and it's not adhesive, that's fine too. In that case, you would put the cardboard underneath and then tape the wire over it. But if your copper is adhesive, then put the wire on the cardboard and then use the copper to tape it on.
And you're covering both the little, what shall we call them? The sparkly wires and the insulated part of the wire with the copper tape?
Yes, just
like the tip of the insulated.
Just the tip of the insulated, yeah, exactly. And you can see that I definitely left too much of my uninsulated wire sticking out. So I'm gonna trim that off a little so it doesn't hang off the edge of my cardboard. So you tape one side, flip it over, tape the other side. And just gently pat it down, make sure it's semi-secure. So this is what I am adapting. I'm going to open up the battery compartment. And I find the easiest place to put a battery interrupter is on the positive end of the battery. So the sticky out end. And you're going to make sure that it connects with your copper foil square. And you're going to replace the battery with the copper foil square in between that positive end and where it connects. And of course that did not click, hold on. It may be a little bit of a squeeze.
Yeah, mine was too big at first. I just had to turn it on.
All right. Now, if this was a toy that you permanently want to use for this purpose, then sometimes it's helpful to take a metal like file and file off a little bit of plastic at the edge of the battery compartment so that your cord will lie flat when it's coming out. This is where like a lot of people might be dumb. You know, if you have a kid who needs a specific type of switch particularly, then you can use any regular store-bought switch that you already know works well for them. Just plug it into the end of the battery interrupter, you're good to go. But I am going to teach everyone how to make a cheap DIY switch so that you can have fun playing with your new toy. If any of you have ever made a CD switch before, this is the exact same concept, just using old gift cards or hotel keys or whatever instead of CDs. So the idea is that we're going to, much the same as the battery interrupter, kind of interrupt and then close the circuit. So I've got two plastic cards and I've got my copper tape. And this is where it's an advantage to have slightly wider copper tape. I'm sorry, Megan. And we're going to either, you can put tape on, just on the outside edges. You can put tape just in the middle. You can cover the whole thing with copper. And the way you'll make that decision is, bye, thanks for coming. The way you'll make that decision is how difficult you want it to be to activate. So I have, where'd it go? I have one here that I think I just put copper tape in the middle. Yeah. So this one just has a strip of tape in the middle, if you can kind of see that. So that means that I have to push directly in the middle to activate it, which is a little more pressure than if I had put copper all over so that hitting anywhere on the switch would activate it. You're going to want to do it both one side of two cards.
Okay.
One side each. And they should be symmetrical. So whatever you decide, if you decide you're only doing copper in the middle, or if you decide you're coppering the whole thing, just do it the same way on both. So our next step, well, why don't we pause this and do some more wire stripping? So the other end of the audio cable that we had set aside, the male end, is going to be what we're using to make our switch. So you might want to use the full length that you set aside. You might want to trim it down a little. It's up to you, however far away your user usually is from the toy there or appliance or whatever they're playing with. I like to just leave mine long because I don't know, what if I want to use it for a train or something, then just want to let it go away from me. So we're going to do the same thing that we did for the first step of the battery interrupter. We're going to strip off about 2 inches or so of the thick black plastic coating. And then after that, we'll strip the interior. So mine, once again, has these loose coppery bits that are just grounding wire that I don't need. So I'm going to cut those out. And if you have the same situation going on, you might, at the end of your battery interrupter or your switch, want to take a little piece of electrical tape or something and just cover that joint so that no sticky out bits of wire are poking. But anyway, once you're down to your just two internal wires, pick any two, and then we're going to strip the coating off of those as well. All right, so I'm going to take back out my copper coated cards, and then I'm going to get out my foam mounting tape or squares, whatever you have available. And where you put these, again, it kind of depends on where you put your copper and what sort of activation force you want to use. So if I wanted this to be like really, really easy to activate, I would probably put them both sort of on one side so that this edge would be really close together and my user would be able to just tap or swipe the very edge. If I want it to be a little less sensitive and just put it in the middle, if I want it to be really hard to activate, I could use four and put them on all four corners.
So basically these little pieces just separate the two copper sides enough so that they're not constantly touching.
Right.
Okay.
So, and how many you use and where you put them will kind of determine how difficult it is to make those copper sides touch. I'm going to put them in the middle. So once you decide where you want them to go, you're going to take your wires and stick them to one side, one on each side of a single square. So they're both on the same square. The other square is just for positioning.
Do they need to be, does the little square need to be on the insulation?
Yes. Okay. Overlapping a little bit. Thank you.
Gotcha. Okay.
I just don't like leaving Yeah, leave an uncovered wire hanging out anywhere.
So should I trim my copper that's, is this copper? Yeah, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
What are you doing, Kat? You, the extra that's hanging off, you can trim off. Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right.
So I have one wire on each side of my foam square, and then I'm going to pick where I want to put my foam square, and I'm just going to stick it down. Oops. That didn't stick.
Mine was not very sticky. Okay, I got it.
Here we go. And then the other foam square, or three other foam squares, however many you're using just for positioning, you can just peel and stick wherever they're going to go. Beautiful. So once your foam squares are where you want them, you just stick your other card on top with the copper side facing downwards, make a little sandwich. So this is your makeshift switch. You've got your toy with your battery interrupter. So how do we use these? The most important part that people usually forget is to make sure the toy is turned off first. I'm going to put the battery interrupter that I just made into a toy that really is just on off.
So when I press down, it's playing, and when I release, it's not playing.
Exactly.